What do we do? Oh, my. You laugh. Dream analysis. Let our experts unlock the mystery of your dreams. Numerology. Let the numbers guide you through important life decisions. Reaching beyond. Connect with loved ones who have crossed over to the other side. Now, I want to equip you to minister in the world that we live in. You know why I said that? Because you work with people who have clicked on these links, who look to the horoscope, look to the numbers, call the psychic hotline, call... Oh, now listen, now I heard a good one on that. It said, why does psychics have to ask you your name? That's a good question. Listen, I mean, you ride right up all the 19 and... you know, there's a neon sign, get your reading. And I want to talk to you about reading the leaves. Reading the leaves. You know, all of these things are mimics of what really does work.
Right.
A relationship with God.
That's right.
The devil, and I said it, yeah, I said it. The devil, he doesn't want you to talk to God and he doesn't want you to hear from God. He wants to shame you into staying in the corner and not saying a word, and you're the little Christian in the corner. Keep your Bible to yourself. Don't quote nothing out loud. Don't learn it. Don't teach it. Don't share it. Just stay right there and you'll be okay. Mm-hmm. The devil wants to box you in the corner, make you doubt. He wants to fill you with deception, and these are just some of the things that are working on your coworkers.
That's right.
Listen, it seems like there would be a lottery winner every week. Right? Doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, come on now. Let me tell you, I just want to share. I want to share with you, this fools a lot of people. Why? Because there are a lot of things that are common to human beings. A lot of things that are common. We all want peace. Peace of mind. We all miss loved ones who have passed away, don't we? Huh? If we could hear from them, wouldn't it be nice? Oh, yeah. Come on, there's things that we want, things that we enjoy, things that pleasure us, that are common to us all. And what they'll do, they'll use common little things that just might fit. And then the stretch of your faith makes it fit. Knock on wood. Yeah, there you go. Have you ever seen a coworker do that? Huh? Oh, that's for Micah. I'm just saying. I would like to show you a little something that I found on the internet. No, like I said, forgive me for this. I'd like for you to show the T slide there. This is reading the leaves. Oh, I wish it was bigger. I'll explain it to you. If you didn't know, this is a tea cup. Okay, and a teacup has like a saucer, or it could be the bottom of the cup. I hadn't figured that out yet. Anyway, and you take it to someone who can read the tea leaves, and what you do is you drink tea with a little bit of leaves in it, and you take big gulps, and you leave a little bit in the bottom of the tea the teacup, and you swirl it around to the left, not to the right, to the left in a circular motion, and then either you dump it out in the saucer, yeah, I think so, in some cultures you just look at the bottom of the cup, I don't know, anyway, and then, your life path and your future is right there on the bottom of the saucer. In the tea leaves. Now, I know this is small, but I wish you could see this larger. If you notice, number one is an anchor. Number two is a, it's an axe or a seven, I think. Number four is a palm tree. There's a heart up there, two triangles, and the letter L. So somebody named the letter L is going to take an axe and put a hole in your boat. You're going to be stranded on an island with a palm tree. But don't worry, a couple triangles are going to float up, and your heart is going to be overjoyed, even though it's all a mess. Some people are good at that. Ain't that right, Brother Fahmy? We know people, don't we? Huh? We know people who could do that. Now, I've never been one to do that. But some of the people that you work with make life choices based on reading the leaves. Okay. Let's go on to that palm one. Some things start to show up here that make it kind of iffy. I don't know. You don't get the whole effect because the bottom is gone. But and you know what? I was looking at this on the internet, and I started wanting to look at my hand. I said, no. No, no, I'm not going to look at my hand. And nobody copy this down and go later and say, oh, no! What does that blister mean? It's a rough road to hoe. Uh-oh. My lifeline is split in two. What does that mean? If you notice something starts to appear that's kind of like the sun, Saturn, Jupiter, there's some planet names. I guess maybe if you hold your hand up to the stars, and when Mars comes over here, and this little piggy goes to market. I don't know. Yeah. Why do you think that neon light is still on?
That's right.
Because some of the people that you interact with, by faith, reach out, and they look at that, and they make decisions in their life that impact their eternity. I don't want to scare you all this morning, but you know, we have a lot of different people. Some people are atheists. Here, let me show you. It's a blank one. It's gone. It just disappeared. Look at that. Oh. Does that not work? Oh, there it is. That's what they trust in. I don't know if that fills the void or not. Does it do it for you? It doesn't really do it for me. Then in schools, they'll teach us about evolution. Now, don't be offended at this picture, but I couldn't fit all the monkeys in there. Or the end result, it just wouldn't all fit. You know, and the end is kind of like, I don't know. We still have monkeys, and we still have men, yeah. But the rest of them just—I don't know—they it just didn't work. That's what some of the people that you work with believe. Yeah, amen, amen. I'm just telling you like it is. Now listen, it goes deeper than that. And like I said, I don't want to be offensive this morning, but I read a little bit about a new religion that the army just assigned some ministers for a few years ago, called Wicca. Yeah, witchcraft. Yeah, so many of them that the army has soldiers who are Wiccan. They're nice people. I got a few things that they believe. You know, they really look at the... they look at the earth, and they don't really, they worship the devil, they worship the earth. And they said things like, take a Bible and lay it out in the sun, and after a while, it'll be gone. But the earth will still be there. And so, Here's it says, Wiccans have great reverence for the earth. and for their goddess and her consort, the horned god. Yeah, take it down. Yeah. Does that look innocent to you? If that ain't the devil, I don't know what is. You know, and they say, no, Satanism and Wiccan is just as far away as Christian is from atheism.